Hi, people, and welcome back to Super Robot Wars Original Generation Moondwellers. That's a mouthful. Anyway, I played the guidance mode on the clock. I recorded it. The footage went bad. I tried saving it the best I could. I couldn't. So I can either play it again or anything like that. If you guys want to see it, it was a tutorial. It was interesting. It had Arado and Kai in it. If you know who they are, if you know who Arado is, good for you. If you know who Kai is, yeah, of course you know who Kai is. He's the only guy who would actually pilot a guest Spence over anything else. More than that, we have a next map to go to. Let's sortie! This process will end the intermission. There's nothing to do in this intermission. What in the world? What happened to Ashurai? Could it be Master Iselda? No, that's not right. That's not an attack caused by Granteed. Darn. There are no vital signs. Alvan. Ranks, you went to the outside world without permission. Furthermore, you even brought the Raf clans out. But Asura Kazai was attacked. The one who attacked it then was the guests. Guests unit. But that was not the one that we seized. Oh, keyword is square. Zeren sent from Zolvark to Earth orbit to contain the guests via Terra forces. What? Oh my god. Oh my god! you could go in depth here. Then who did it? I will have the spies investigate this. Also, search for Iselda and Granteed. But I will give you a new assignment. Return to base and execute immediately. That's all. Yes, sir. A new assignment. This is Bezalut! Hey, Tenny! I thought you were dead. Calvina, what happened to my father and mother? There are no vital signs detected anywhere. That can't be! What about Katia and Melua? Please don't make me repeat it. Everybody. Darn it! Hey, she doesn't cuss! The unknown over there. Answer me! Answer me! Is it you who did this? They've already discovered this Raf glands. Did you kill I and the others? Oh, Al. She's yelling at him. Don't you dare escape! Wait! Are you serious about chasing after him? Of course! No way! I don't want to! Be quiet. Mind your own business. You are just a passenger here. I can't leave my parents, Katia and Melua, behind. Let me spell it out for you. They are all dead. The power's down. Darn it. Why of all times? I think I'll miss this chance right when the enemy is in front of me. Al, I'm... Do I not get a choice? I know there's two routes in the beginning, but do I not get a choice or anything? Where's the choice? A new age known as the New AD. Almost two centuries have passed since the full-scale progression of mankind into space, but is also an age where the lives of people do not differ from those back in the start of the 21st century by much. The reason for that was the destruction and confusion caused by the fall of two meteors, stopping the progress of mankind for a period of time. And then new AD 179, the third meteor, Meteor 3, fell into the South Pacific Ocean, off the coast of Maquis. off the Keysmark Archipelago. From the result of investigation conducted by the team under the Terra Federation government, and determined that to be a man-made. It was made of materials and technology completely unknown to mankind, which information on it sealed. Terra teamed as EOT. Furthermore, investigation carried out from them on from the research results to extraordinary genius scientist Bian Zoltarkybian, hinted to the Terra Foundation government and Terra Foundation for I'm not going fast enough! Okay, let's just look at it. Oh god, please tell me they're not summarizing. Oh my god, they're summarizing all the previous games. Okay. I'll try to go like, how the heck am I going to keep up with this? Ah, screw it, I just stopped reading it. It's not really a point if it just goes by so fast. Okay. Here's the route split. I was worried I wasn't going to get it. Okay. I know for a fact that the guaranteed route is the land route, and the space route is the Bezalut route. So we're going to go, for the first playthrough, the land route. Let's go. Since we did it, started having this same dream over again. So when did it start? Sitting alone in that darkness. Dreaming about a girl in a praying posture, looking in my direction. She looks very beautiful, yet with melancholy eyes. She kept saying this all the time. Please, I seek your forgiveness. We have once again broken the taboo. And brought us calamity upon the world itself. Even if that is an inevitable destiny, we have no one else but ourselves to blame. Acting as the key is the royal sword. Perhaps it was I who made you bear such a heavy burden. Forgive me for being weak. That little girl who was in the first part of the SRWJ, I remember you. Upon waking up, every time her words found no place in my memories. So, and all that I could remember was that clear hair surrounded by glittering light particles and such saddened eyes only. It was a sign hinting at the impending battle. But there was no way of knowing this back then. Hey, we're in Japan! The suburb of Sapporo. Do I have to press a button? I do. Ugh, it's the same dream again! Despite seeing it countless times, I still have no idea just who in the world she is. Someone whom I have never seen before, is it possible to see them appearing in my dream? A weird transfer notification. As long as money is provided, children will just grow up on their own. Is that really what you think, Father? It's time. I better get to school fast. Oh my gosh, it's gonna do this every time I change locations, isn't it? You look sleepy, Toya! Were you up late playing Burning PT again? Hey, Burning PT! Who's this guy? Well, it's not... Well, it's not it. Just kinda woke up on the wrong side of the bed. Could it be because of that dream again? Yeah. Your dream is about a beautiful girl who woke you up, right? Unlike me, I can never get tired of my twin sister waking me up every morning. Well, if that's the case, why don't you wake up by yourself then? Couldn't help it! I've been busy lately! You are not the only one who's busy. Well, that's true. That aside, Toya, wouldn't it be better for you to discuss this with the counselor? Since our lecturer recently recommended you to do so? Well, that's true. Hey, Toya! What's this about a counselor? I was told to visit the counselor regularly because I don't have parents to live alone. The lecturers are nervous about how to deal with someone like me. Is that part of the war damage reconstruction? Not really. It seems like previously students who were in a similar situation like mine went missing. I'm gonna guess Meliwa, Katia, and Tanya. With that, I'm guessing that the authority instructed the school to take care of students like me. It's not like you enjoyed living all alone by yourself. You know, Toya, if it's okay with you, I could go to your place to cook at times. That would be a great help, but haven't you been busy? You got that right, especially the day. What's up with the day? Listen, Toya, actually... Alright, STOP is right there. It right there. That's corporate confidential. Oops, that's careless of me. Anyway, I have to go home right away after school. Speaking of corporate confidential, had to be Magani Heavy Industries. These guys are the guys from Super Robot Wars GameCube. This is their first appearance in the OG series as well. Despite being such a big enterprise, to the extent of having the president's children help out with the work, are they that short on manpower? Short of manpower? Japan, within the mountains of Western Sapporo District. Can't we just say we went somewhere else? We're GPU-san.
Such a nice timing. Our clients from Tokyo have just arrived as well. Allow me to introduce it to you. This is...
I'm Kota Azurna.
I'm Shoko, the younger sister. Nice to meet you.
What's wrong with your face?
By any chance, are you compatible Kaiser's pilot, Fighter Roar?
Yes, that would be me.
Really?
Do you know Fighter Roar?
He looks so anime! Like, more anime than these guys! Oh, yes! He is quite famous on the net, having fought the Shura, which appeared in Tokyo. Asakusa's a hero clad in red armor.
Okay, who is it?
That's the wrong button, it's Square!
Name of their combat organization that moved towards the Earth orbit from the alien world Shurikai.
Shura Custom?
And also the name of its members. Okay.
Who would have thought that they are the same age group as us?
This is really surprising, really. I knew Kanpai Kai is famous because it stands out, but I didn't know Fighter Roar is really well known.
What are you talking about? Lots of videos taken by tourists in Asakusa have been on websites.
Really? Well, I was making quite a show by flying around.
Could it be that you didn't realize it? Okay, the translation here is really bad, but it's better than nothing. I'll just try to work out some text errors. No, I don't really check out the internets. Really? Where do you stop then?
I go to the neighborhood stalls for shopping.
I mean online shopping.
I don't do that. It's too troublesome.
Online shopping? Troublesome? If it wasn't for online shopping, the Americans wouldn't have this game! It's okay. Oni-chan doesn't need to be because he hardly uses the DCOM anyway. Name of this general high-efficiency portable terminal, that newest version is issued in film form to Terra Federation forces. Okay. It will be a disaster if Oni-chan starts shopping online. He's such a spendthrift. What is with the anime-style chibis?
Akemi? I believe both of you haven't formally introduced yourselves yet.
Oops, that's right. I'm Akemi Akatsuki, and over here is Akemi Akatsuki.
Akemi and Akemi? Those names are really easily mixed up.
Many people have said that. Nice to meet you, Kota-kun.
Just call me Kota.
Same for you, then.
In any case, Kota and Shoko, appreciate that both of you coming a long way here. Although it's because Grandpa and Jimpo-san have been friends for a long time. But I personally wanted to come because Roar told me that Kaiser fell right here.
Here? Seriously?
Yep. Actually, Combati Kaiser was built in another world, and it got thrown to our world while fighting with the bad guys named Dark Brain. The crash site is well right here at this place, like we're standing on it. The president, Kishiburo, and myself were then there back then.
I didn't know that. And who exactly is Roar?
He was the original pilot for Kampei Kaiser, who had been fighting against Dark Brain, the one who gave me the Roar armor.
And he's not here?
He does not have a body. He now lives in the crystal that is attached to the armor.
Hold on a second, did you say he does not have a body?
Remember, I told you Roar was thrown to our world here when fighting with Dark Brain. When that happened, both Roar and Kaiser ended up in bad shape. Yes. For Roar to survive, he had to choose to forsake his injured body and fuse his body with that crystal. For Kaiser, it was Grandpa who spent time repairing it.
Seems like a lot of intricate happenings.
When Shura no Ran began, Shura appeared in Asakusa. Roar entrusted me with the armor, and that's how I became Fighter Roar. So that's how it happened. Okay, that's all the story. Now let's begin, Akemi. Kota, please get ready.
Roger.
Alright, Jimpo-san. Episode 1. Soul Saber versus Compatible Kaiser.
Okay. What the? Okay, I knew how he looked from the back of the box, but come on!
I didn't notice this when I came in. The area over there is part of the premises. This place sure is spacious.
That's the reason why we could hide the teleportation trails of Capital Kaiser and myself.
It was fortunate that Grandpa and Megami's president, happened to be around when you fell to the ground.
Yes. Just like the fight with Dark Brain and losing the mothership, our place of return.
Dude, okay. Are you putting a costume on every 5 seconds? No, I mean, like, he's in the armor, right? So does that mean you're putting on the cloak whenever he's talking? Like you have, like, a little cloak thing and, like, cloak on the side and go, cloak on. Okay, I'm talking. Cloak on. Roar. Me. Roar. Me. Roar. Me. Just that switch. Oh my god, that would be so annoying!
Mothership? Something like the Hagawana? Hagawane? Oh, please tell me that's not the translation for the Hagane.
Way bigger than that.
Wow. Oni-chan, can you hear me?
Yeah!
Akemi-san's group will be coming soon.
Hey, Shoka! Let's grab something after this, like Uni-don!
Ikura-don or miso ramen.
We can't afford them all! Choose one!
Please, we came all the way to Hokkaido!
We have you coming all the way here. If it's something like Ikura-don, I'll let you have as much as you want.
Wow! I'm glad to hear that!
Spoil him. Mighty Walker operation system all green, power output normal.
Sorry I'm late. Wow, that is the soul food.
Yeah, that's right. You know, Genghis Khan or soup curry. Hey, wait, just wait a minute. I was just playing with a Jinpu-san's joke. You are a good sport to ride on it.
Soul Saber, compatible Kaiser, when put together, they both have human-like faces.
They do? It's a measure that imposes physiology effects to the psychological effects to the opponent. It was Kisaburo's suggestion. It's the same concept as the Neo-Guardian statues.
I understand your example, but it's not too bad.
Well then, we'll start off the mock battle with FF equipment.
Be sure to do it properly, Kimmy.
Roger, Jinpo-san.
What's FF?
FF is the abbreviation for Fighter Fist. It refers to the highly mobile close combat equipment. With that being said, I'm the main pilot for this form.
With GG equipment being the other form, it's designed to work heavier armor and long-range weaponry. The main pilot of that form is me.
Does this transform like Hugo or a Garmin Blaze?
No, we have to change the armament in our hangars.
Really? That's troublesome.
We could perform the transformation mechanism, but in return, the structure becomes complex. Add hassle for maintenance and ends up increased production costs. The compete with mechs
from Tesla Lesh Institute, Mao Industries, and Isuruki Heavy Industries,
we need to focus on cost, maintainability, and simplicity.
Jinpu-san, are you trying to sell Soul Saber to the Terra Foundation Federation forces?
Well, it's not like the Soul Saber is being developed solely for profits. After all, this is a company, and life would be tough had we been a charity organization. In that sense, Kisaburo-san is amazing. Irregardless of profit, he is able to do various things.
Well, Grandpa has lots of money. I've never seen it,
and it's never reflected in our daily lives.
That's a given. Apart from Grandpa's research and development maintenance-related expenses, he would just spend the money on everything else. I'm not supervising the whole process.
You are indeed very reliable, Shoko-chan.
She's just being miserably Jinpu-san. Just how are you going to sell to the Federation Force?
Well, although I'm going to mass-produce models for the personal trooper armored modules, currently majority of the Super Robot are somewhat akin to limited edition items.
Indeed, there are lots of unique types like Combat Tai Kaiser, which is one too many.
Well, there's also the choice of producing many mass product types and compete with sheer quantity, but many of the alien mechs and creatures are rather tough. We'll have a hard time if that's the case. That's exactly why both the president and myself are staring at the news regarding mass production of super robots. So we started to develop a plan for product that is strong, low cost, and easy to manage. Of course, for a prototype like Soul Saber, we don't limit ourselves for the budget, as it's meant for demonstration.
I see. The reason why we are here as the test pilots is to appeal the relative ease of the handling aspect through demonstration.
I am not going to stop here just like that.
Not again. I suppose the Federation pilots will eventually be piloting these.
Hey, doesn't it grow on you?
We brought it to a level where we can do it during simulation. We'll be able to perform the same during the real combat.
What are you talking about? I no longer want to go through the feeling of helplessness again, like in Shura no Ran. Both Kota and Shoko were fighting. With Soul Saber, I could too! Don't talk big for a newbie! Kota and Shoko have been through the battlefield more times than you can imagine. Plus, the president would object to it. Don't you remember the commotion caused when you said you wanted the test pilots?
But we can't allow the Soul Saber which we worked so hard on to end up being used for other purpose besides terror defense.
Of course, the President and I have the same opinion, but as a weapon manufacturer, this is not something we have a say in. Okay, let's start the mock battle. The President has requested to see the test data soon.
Akemi, as I said, the opponent is quite experienced. You just go for it.
Roger, Akemi. Let's do it. Akemi, not Akemi. She's Akemi. He's Akemi. Roger. I'll toughen you up. Bring it on!
With full victory condition, with Soul Saber undamaged. Strike. Okay, it doesn't look bad.
Akemi, their power output is higher than us. If that's the case,
I know, we'll compete with speed.
Kota, they are not accustomed to battle. Don't go too hard on them.
Even so, I can't just go easy on them. They won't learn anything then.
Wait, why am I going first? They're attacking me.
Oh.
To 3,000 and below. What's his HP?
I want that battle mastery.
Don't hit.
Are you kidding me?
Yes, I just restarted the game.
So you can't skip the cutscenes, okay.
I'll probably just restart the game next time I do this. Let me restart the recording. Gotta do this whole thing again, huh? Okay, he'll attack me. No rate, evasion rate, no change. I might just jump on the buildings. Yeah, I like that. It works. Oh, I attacked first because I activated a counter, didn't I? Okay. I want to see if I can get him to come to me. Okay, he does come to me. Alright, this was smart. Using the built. Do I have just have counter, or do I have like auto counter or something? Because I keep attacking first. Are those shuttles? They look like shuttles! You have 1% chance, you better not stink and hit me. What's it doing? One percent. Okay. I get ammo. Perfect. Hopefully they just nerf this guy for this, because to make it easier on me.
Wait, aren't I attacking him? Why did he go first? Okay. Might be able to pull this off with the building helping me. Take a 13. I guess they both have counter or something. With a thing like 13%, I'm just freaking nervous. You know, like, anything can stick and happen. Okay, we got him down to 9,000. Phew. Oh no. He's on the building, so he recovers! And it goes up to 40%. She's done. And he has nothing. Oh. I actually wanted to see that attack, but okay. Please don't hit. Dang! You were skewered. I think I would have won if I didn't have him. Okay. I'll catch you all in a minute. I'm going to try doing this again. Okay, we're back. Best tip I can give you? Go over here on this little thing here and he'll come up to you. Yeah, don't go to him. Have him come to you.
He now doesn't have the defensive boost, and he also doesn't have the HP regen, which he had when I was on, when he was on the hangar as well, and I completely forgot about that. Yeah. I didn't think about that when I was doing it. But yeah, best course of action, just come over here. You're good. Okay. And we have plenty of focus to actually get us through this. See? Plenty of focuses. Because this should actually end it. Just drill missile him till he's dead. Just drill missile him. Are you kidding me? Technically, I should finish him on the counterattack. Oh, if you hit me at 13%, I'm gonna be so pissed. Oh, I would have been so pissed! This is actually the most annoying battle mastery I've actually ever seen. More annoying than actually killing someone, more annoying than taking someone out in 2 turns, more annoying than attacking someone and then leaving one guy alive at 5%. I remember that one from OG2, okay, so I know that one. I did it like 2 days ago. What would I have gotten if I actually killed him? Alright, that's enough. You did much better than I expected. Ability is excellent, although you said it is simple and sturdy. Did you see that, Jinpu-san? I did rather well against compatible Kaiser. Don't push your luck. They did it in normal mode. Without G-Thunder Gate. Soul Saber's getting its flying unit developed too, ain't it? Oh, you're actually making that kind of thing. Yeah! That includes an additional weapon. It's not compatible, though. Complete, though. We'll need us to somehow fix that power output issue for Soul Saber before fitting it further with Saber Booster. Well, then. I'm next in line. Okay, return now and change the GG equipment. Gota, please take a break for a while. Well then, I'll return as well. What do you think, Akemi? I beat compatible Kaiser with FF equipment. It's your turn, Akemi. Don't disappoint me with GG equipment. Jeez, keep quiet, will you? I have more than 30 things to check for during the mock battle. Both of you, there's an incoming transmission from the president. He should be at the maritime plant right now? Wonder what it is all about. I'm taking the transmission from here.
Akemi! Seems like the FF equipment is almost ready.
Yes, we're now starting the mock battle with the GG equipment.
We're going to deliver them to Federation Force after the mock battle and the final checkup.
That day is going to take a while.
Don't you have attachment? We have to say goodbye to our Soul Saber.
We have a second one.
That's just a spam. We have another? Wait, then why can't they both be pilots? Like one GG and one an FF. That's just a spare, and we barely used it anyway.
After Unit 1 has been delivered, this will be our ride back. Furthermore, it will be used for Soul Booster's development.
By the way, I love you guys along with Kota-kun to...
Father?
What is that?
What is going on?
The sky! Can you see it from your end?
Transmission got disconnected! What's going on over there?
You mentioned the sky. Let's go outside and take a look.
Ah!
Well, we actually finished the scenario.
And we got the SR point! Yes!
G-compatible Kaiser. Compatible Kaiser. G-Thundergate. Okay, so this is apparently two units. Okay, that's good to know. Soul Saber. First score. Modify. Wow, okay. So, in this game, like in J, they've gotten rid of the fact you upgrade each weapon individually. You just upgrade everything at once. Okay, I like that. We have you. Now we have you. And now he's just in the G-Thundergate mode. He's a B. He's better on land and space, okay. He has potential level. What?! He has potential level 7?! Counter level 6 and resolve!
Wow!
It has an E field. Okay. She's apparently the sub-pilot. She has mediate and chain attack.
You've ca-
Yeah, you both have really high level counters. Assist attack and potential. Okay, that's nice. No, hidden away. You have hidden away?! I was planning on using the GG form for this run because it seemed more super robot-y. Okay, this, how much does it take? It takes 250 PP points! Okay, a lot more than the original generation. The original was just the first game, it was 40. Assist attack again. Attack again. Okay, this is where skill comes into handy. Okay. Revenge during a counterattack. Deal 1.2 times more damage. Consumes 20% less SP when using Spirit Commands or Twin Spirit Commands. Okay, she has Mediate, so that's something. She's a support unit through and through. SP up. Yeah. Resolve. Seems I can't buy that. On player start phase, pilots will increase by 2. Okay. Will evade. Evaded when pylons went by 1 every time they evade. When they hit an enemy, when they... Whoa, actually, that's pretty good. That actually might be useful to get. You know? You have counter. Okay, so, that's probably for the assist attack thing that they mentioned before. In the guidance mode, which you guys didn't get to see because the footage got corrupted. Gotta remember that. So that means, like, they mentioned that...
a main sub-mech attacks a sub-main mech, damage penalty reduced by 20%. You save consumes 30% less energy when using weapons. Increases ammo by 1.5. Beast Be Up gains 1.2 more experience from battle.
Really now?
That's actually nice. Learning. Gains an equal amount of EXP and PP as the main mech when fighting as the sub-mech. Basically, that's a support skill. Hit and Weigh is always useful. Predict. When the pilot's will is 130 and above, hit rate and evasion rate increase by 10. Guard. Receive 20% less damage when pilot's will is above. Okay, that's good to know.
Russell probably has that. And that's what happened to Guard. Replaced by Fortitude. Okay. I found Guard.
And the fourth one is Potential, which is always amazing. Continuous action. When defeating an enemy mech with pilot's will 120 and above, the mech gains additional turn.
It's SD Gundam G Generation's ability! It's the extra step! That is amazing.
So you're a defensive type, and you're an attack type.
Wait a minute.
Oh, it's because you have counter and potential, and she has an actual unique skill, so it's not listed anymore, because that's why she has one less skill. Okay. Wait, you have resolve? Oh, that's why I can't buy it. You already have it.
Wait.
She can't learn Chain Attack! Neither can he! Huh. Transfer Pilot! Oh, that'll be useful later. Team Formation? I'll look into that later. These are still confusing to use. Well, upgrading this thing, upgrade both of them. Because in old SRW games, when there's a combiner actually upgradable, you upgrade the combiner, you upgrade both all the sub-robots. Only if you can launch in the combiner, though. But this combiner is listed as their main mech. That's the only reason I'm asking. Other than that, thank you guys for joining me. I've been taking up too much of your time. Remember to like, comment, and subscribe. I've just been having fun going through this. I'll probably do a save and then check it out in a minute. Till next time, guys. Doodles!